Hi, Jules here for day 7 of Epiphany's 31 Days of Tarot. Today's prompt asks what my most worked with tarot deck was in 2021 and why. I tend to cycle through all of my decks on a monthly basis. I used to go month to month, and now I go based on astrological seasons. So I go through my decks and consider what might have the best energy for that particular astrological season, and I combine a lot of decks together just to make sure that I'm actually going through and using all of them. I love all of the artwork and all of my tarot and oracle decks so much, and they all are important to me for different reasons. There are two, however, that I tend to gravitate towards on a regular basis. The first of those is the Starseeker Tarot by Nikki from the Van Mystic. There's just something about the aesthetic of this deck that feels very comforting and very soothing. I use this one a lot for readings for other people. I find it has just a very nice, calm, soothing and supportive energy to it. Even some of the more challenging cards feel very nurturing, especially because of Nikki's beautiful writing in the guidebook. This particular guidebook, the insights are so beautiful. For example, the Nine of Swords tends to be a challenging card. That's one of the cards associated with my birthday. It's a fear and anxiety card, and as someone who deals with a lot of insomnia and anxiety, it can be very challenging to deal with. But the way that Nikki expresses this particular card in the guidebook is really helpful for me. I appreciate her insights so much. The other deck that is a top go-to for me is, of course, the Pacific Northwest Tarot by Brendan Marnell. This deck, there's just something about the aesthetic that just, I don't know, it resonates on such a deep level, like the colors and the imagery. It's so lovely. Sorry for the change in sound. Our vent just turned off with the heating. And all of these gorgeous animals. I mean, I love being out in nature so much, and these images just resonate for me on such a deep level. And I appreciate all of the care and time that's gone into all the images and the artwork. And also the guidebook that comes with it is really beautiful. There's lovely insights. Those are my two kind of most prominent decks for 2021. They're the ones that when I need a bit of TLC or I just instinctually grab something, that is what I gravitate towards. So I would love to know what was your top or couple of top decks for 2021. Thanks.